If you want to be a successful reseller, you have got to figure out what people want and what they are looking for. And we're going to talk about one of those things in this video, so stay tuned. Hello, my name is Margaret and welcome to my channel, Texas Gal Treasures. I am a homeschooling reselling mom that is making money to support my family by selling things on eBay and Etsy, amongst other things. But in this video, we are going to be talking about one particular item that I look for over and over again that always does well for me, and that is figural animals. So I get a lot of comments asking me, what do I look for? What should I be looking for at the thrift stores? What kinds of things are selling for you? And one thing that I notice repeatedly that I like to pick up that I sell constantly are figural items. Now, what am I talking about here? I am talking about animals, bugs, things of that nature, because if you think about it, everybody you know probably has a favorite something, a something they collect, a something they really like, whether it's frogs or dragonflies or arapaima, for crying out loud. The weirder the better. So this is what I'm going to talk to you guys about in this video, is how to know which of those types of items to pick up so that when you go to resell them, you will have a buyer waiting. I'm going to be pulling up actual items that have sold, and I'm going to talk to you guys about why I picked it up and why I really knew that somebody was going to want this item. So when I'm looking for figural items, I really have three things I'm looking for. One, is it something that's unique? Two, is it something that's made well? And three, is it something that's unusual? So one, when I say something is unique, I mean, is it a type of animal that you don't always see everywhere? We see panda bears everywhere, frogs everywhere. Now, I do still pick those up, but I'm looking for the unusual. So if I see an arapaima fish, or if I see a Komodo dragon, something that's unusual that you don't see day after day after day, those are things that are for sure gonna pick up. Two, is it well made? Now, when I talk about picking up figural items, I'm not talking about things that are made from like cheap resin that look like they were picked up from the dollar store that just look terrible. I'm talking about things that are porcelain, glass, wood, things that are carved that look like they were made with care and that will hold up over time. And three, unique. I'm really looking for, if it is a turtle, I'm looking for something that is an artistic twist on it, something that's weird, something that somebody won't already have. So if you're thinking, oh, I want to buy this really cool frog gift for my friend Christina, but she's got a bazillion frogs. How do I know that this is going to be a frog I can buy for her and she will not have it? So you want to make sure if you see something like a frog that is just wackadoodle looking, then that's something you want to pick up, because that is going to be something that, because you will know your friend doesn't have that one. It's funny because just as I'm shooting this video, I got a cha-ching, something sold. And what was it? It was a funkadoodle rooster. Now, I want to reiterate that some of these figural items of animals that are more dime a dozen, that you see a little more often, they can still sell. But I would be more hesitant on picking them up and paying attention to that ROI, that return on investment that you're going to see off of that, and making sure that you pick it up for a cheap enough price. So let's dive in. I'm going to share with you guys my Etsy sales and my eBay. Now, when I look at Etsy, I like that because on those sold, I can go back from to the beginning of when I started selling, and I can really look at all the different things that have sold. On eBay, I think it cuts off after 90 days, but we'll look at those too. So if you'll see, this is my Texas Gal Treasures shop on Etsy. I've had 1,133 sales, so I'm going to click on that so we can go and look at my sold and see what's a recurring theme. Hello Kitty, that's a kitty. Now, I do talk about figural things. We're talking just about animals, but there, as you see, there will be other things along the way that are also figural. Here we've got this camel box. Here we've got this red bird. Here we've got this bull. Another thing which I didn't get a chance to talk about earlier was that if you can hit multiple, like if this bull covers Taurus, it covers stock traders, it covers, there are many different people that would want that bull. That's a bonus animal. All right, so that's it for that page. I'm gonna dive deeper into some of these in just a minute. So we've got this turtle, we've got this swan, we'll talk about celestial stuff later. We've got a hummingbird. All right, we'll and again, I see some other things that we can dive into later as far as non-figural, non-animal things. So butterfly, butterfly, butterfly. We've got a dolphin. So just be thinking about the people you know and the kinds of animals, especially popular animals right now, sloth, panda, penguin, probably koala, now that we've had that fire, poor koalas. So probably people are going to be looking for koala stuff, you know. Here's this bird, and this was an unusual one. Let's talk about unusual real fast, because unusual, this one was a quetzal, which I was so grateful that one of you guys told me what kind of bird this was. So, okay, let's talk about this. Let's just dive in on this one. So, what did I say? One, I want it to be unique. So, finding a pendant with a quetzal is very unique. It's not something you're going to find all the time. My second rule is quality. Now, this item has not got amazing quality. It's chipped, it's got some age to it. However, some people like that distressed look. And that number one, that it's unusual, is going to bypass all of that because somebody is going to be looking for a quetzal. The fact that it's got a little bit of scuff, it's well loved. Well, you know what? That they might be able to overlook that. If it was demolished, maybe not. And then, is it unique? Is it something that isn't, just a little figurine? Yeah, it looks like it could be used as a necklace or a zipper pull. It's an ornament of some kind that somebody could use to do something else. So it's got almost all three. The fact that its condition is not amazing wasn't deterring from it too much. This sold pretty quickly. And I'll pop the price up here because I'll have to look it up. All right, so let's dive deeper into some of these other ones that I pulled up. This is a piece one. Is it unusual? It's not an unusual animal. It is an owl, but a lot of people like owls. They're hot. Two, quality. It was amazing quality. It was a Zuni brooch. Three, is it unique? So yeah, maybe it wasn't an unusual animal, but it was a unique piece because it was Zuni. It was made like a mosaic. So two out of three, check. All right, here we've got this red bird ornament. This was one that was so cheap I couldn't get it. I couldn't not get it. It was 10 cents, got it at the bins. One, is it an unusual animal? You say that three times fast. It was not necessarily an unusual animal because we see birds, we see red birds. I hadn't seen a chubby red bird like this though. Normally, this kind of bird I see is a bluebird. So yeah, I guess it was a little unusual. One, two, the quality. Yeah, it was amazing quality. And three, was it an unusual piece or a unique piece? And it was somewhat unique. I mean, it was a cool, like blown glass sort of art glass bird. So yeah, okay. All right, next up, this is something that I was actually on the fence about buying because I see this sort of like Bali style hammered metal box all a lot. Maybe not a lot, but it's not something I don't ever, like think I never see this, but I see this type of style. But I thought, okay, it's a camel. I don't see camels all the time. Is it well made? It was really well made. It was super cool. It has buckle on the side. It had so many cool features. And three, was it unique? That made it unique for me. And the price was, I think, $2 or $3. So I'll pop that up here. And it sold really, really fast. All right, next up, there's that bull that I was talking about, and he had the bonus animal because I didn't talk about that. Like, you've got multiple buyers for one item, then you really have found a winner. Was he unusual? Yeah, I don't see bulls all the time. Was he well made? Yes, he was silver plate. He was heavy. He had some wear on him, but I just left it in case someone liked it. And then was he unique? Yeah, he's this like modernist sort of sculpture abstract bull. So he was super cool. So he was a winner and he had multiple buyers, people that would want him. So that's a double check. Okay, now look at this tortoise. Okay, this is what I'm talking about when I was talking about unique. Is a turtle something that we never see? No. So it's not unusual to find turtles and tortoises. Was it well made? Eh. It's weird. I mean, it's metal and it's really lumpy and weird in certain areas. So well made? Meh. Unique? Absolutely. So I really thought that this weird little turtle was gonna find a home. Somebody was gonna love it and wanna bring it home. And I know that if my friend Christina collects turtles, then she's not gonna have this turtle. So I don't have to worry about is she gonna have one like this because I have never seen one like this before. All right, let's look at just a couple more. Panda. Pandas we see a lot of, but pandas are super popular. So Was this an unusual animal to find? No, because I see pandas a lot. Was it well made? It was well made. And three, was it unique? I don't know, but it's a mug, so there's another bonus there because people can give mugs as gifts. Mug, favorite animal equals easy gift. So there's that. All right, another turtle. So this was it looked wood, but it was really resin, I believe, dark wood tone. Yeah. And so this was one, was it a unique animal? No, but it was so well made. I mean, the details and the carving on this were so, so good. And then uniqueness, it wasn't super unique as far as like the other turtle, like weird unique. But this one sold really, really quickly. This one I got at an estate sale. I don't see swans all the time, so unusual. I would say a check on that because I don't see a lot of swans. Was it well made? Absolutely. And then was it unique? It had a crown on it. That was kind of unique. That made it a little bit different than maybe other swans than just like a swan figurine. So this is where that gift giving turns into function. So like the mug and a panda. Well, this is like the hummingbird and the light. So it's like, oh, I don't want to just give her a figurine because that's just blah. Ooh, but I can give her a night light that's got her favorite animal on it. Now we've got a double duty. That's a win, right? So we've got the hummingbird, the night light, boom. We've got, let's see, unusual animal. I see hummingbird stuff. Is it well made? I guess so. I mean, the carving is not awesome. And then is it unusual? It is kind of unusual. It's carved strangely. It's a nightlight out of a shell. So, but then I guess also you've got other buyers there too, if you want to look at it that way. So you've got hummingbird people, you've got shell people. I guess there's nightlight people. But there's somebody that collects everything, y'all. Okay. All right, moving on. Next item. These three went to the same buyer. So one, are they an unusual animal to find? No, butterfly stuff everywhere. Two, were they well made? Yes, they were cloisonné. They looked really nice. The painting, the etching, the enamel, all this stuff looked really, really good. And then were they unique? They were unique. They were cloisonné, which is another thing some people really like to buy. So it had the cloisonné aspect. It had ornaments because they were hanging. They were also butterflies. So it hit, again, those, you know, function and the favorite animal, boom. Combination. And these are just my recent eBay sales. This is an armadillo that sold. So do I see armadillos a lot? No. Was he well made? Absolutely. And was he unique? Yes. He's an armadillo bootjack. So again, you got your favorite animal and you've got Texas and you've got bootjack. So you've got winning combination. All right. So we've got this crane. Is it unusual? Yes, I don't find cranes all the time. Is it well made? Yes, it was really well made. It was metal, this cool sculpture. Was it a unique item? It was fairly unique. I think it was supposed to have a partner, but hey, maybe somebody's husband took one in the divorce and they need to get it back. So anyway, unique enough. All right, here we've got this frog. This is one. Is it an unusual item to find? No. Was it well made? Yes. Is it a unique kind of shape of a frog? Kind of. I mean, I don't always see them climbing like this, so that made it kind of unique. And then here's this cool cat, okay? Is it something you see all the time? Yeah, cat stuff is everywhere. Was it well made? Yes, it was Jim Shore. It was amazing. Was it unique? I ask you, was it unique? Yes, I almost kept it. It was so unique. And then this, look at this guy. So, is he unusual? Yeah. Do you find bird god brooches all the time? Absolutely not. Was he well made? Yeah, he had a little bit of wear on his beak, but I really thought that wasn't going to detract from his amazingness. And then three, was he unique? Did I say unusual first? Unusual? Yeah. Unique? Yes. He had it all. He had it all going on. So he was definitely a yes on the pickup. So those are my three rules for picking up figural items. Are they an unusual piece? Are they well made? And are they unique? And if you can find a bonus animal, then even better. If it's going to combine favorite animal and function, then bonus animal. Go down there and leave me a comment letting me know what is the latest animal figural item that you have sold, and I will catch you on the next one. If it's going to combine favorite animal and function, then bonus animal. Make sure you hit that bell next to the subscribe button because I've got more coming out in this series and you won't want to miss them. And I'll see you later. Bye, everybody.